Dude, I had the most tires, so and I was proud of it. I was like, hey guys, I got shit. I'm late to the fucking class every day. And it's like, yeah, I mean, she got the worst fucking tires in the whole school. Thank you.
Fucking rude. Hopefully they have some new merch out here.
We'll go up to that second level. So not this level, but the second level. So the line will go up that way. Does that make sense? Cool. Does anybody have any questions? Cool. I'm gonna go get the band.
I think it's gonna be a lot of time to stand up.
Yeah. You knew this day would come.
There's no way.
Yeah. shit. This is the warmest welcome I think we've ever gotten in this part of the country. Holy fuck. See which side is louder. The left side or the right side? So you don't have to move, but we're cutting it down the middle. And on this side, you guys are gonna go first. And I need you to scream as loud as you can on the count of three. And here's the deal. You guys go first, and you only get to go once. They have the benefit of going second. Almost every night, the side that goes first loses. We're gonna fucking change that shit tonight!
Fuck yeah!
So with everything you've got, on the count of three, one, two, three, scream! 110 decibels, that's fucking loud.
Alright, so my man Squid in the back of the room over there has a decibel meter, and he's telling us how loud y'all are. So this just isn't an opinion-based competition. This is the real shit. Now,
scientifically,
before this and after this, I love y'all, alright? But right now, you're my fucking enemy. I hate you, and you're a bunch of losers. Alright? There it is, baby. Yeah. Yeah, fuck me. Alright, you guys ready? Let's fucking go!
find a mission. Jesus in this element, the top of it. I wish I had a minute, I was hating the man. But the demons that are moving in my fake head. Maybe I can listen to the greatest friend. Maybe then you will listen to who we hate to say. I can take my land, I'm like a brain in it. Make a deal with the devil, maybe play a red. We only let the twist until I'm free of them. I'll keep on living with the poison till the day I'm dead. I'm gonna go.
you sound incredible. Thank you so fucking much. Because, you know, we grew up and are evolving into a world that is interconnected constantly, all the time. We've got phones, we've got social media, we've got all these means of instantaneously connecting. And at the same time, we are more alone and more isolated than ever before. Now, you know how many times have you been in a room and everybody's just... I think that shit is not a real connection, and that's why we feel so fucking alone. We're completely absorbed into it. Social media is not fucking social, shit's garbage. Tonight, and especially tonight, especially the way that this energy feels in this room, what's happening right here, right now, this is the real connection. This is what it means to be a human. This is the human spirit on its fucking fullest. But if you still feel alone despite all that, even if you're screaming your brains out, you feel like you're standing here alone, I promise you that every single one of us on this stage and everybody in this crowd here tonight, they're all with you. Because when you come to a From Ashes to New show, you are not fucking alone. I promise you that. That being said, we're gonna keep playing some more music, the thing that brings us together. You guys cool with that shit? Put a hand in the air if you've been in a shitty relationship. I mean, you should probably put up too, me too. Now keep those hands up if you stayed way too long. All right, this song goes out to all those relationships where you wish you hated them and they should have hated you too. This one's called Hate Me Too, sing along. Thank you.
is exactly what the fuck we are doing. I remember when I started this band in 2013, I didn't bring this many people to a local show at home on the East Coast. And I remember the first few times that we played in LA or in the LA area, and there was like 20 people that showed up. You remember? 30 people. Next time, 100 people. Next time, 200 people. Don't fucking give up. If you got a dream, just keep going. Who gives a fuck? We just kept going. 2013, mixing rap and metal together was not cool. It was one of the most uncool things that you could do. I never gave a fuck about what was cool. And never gave a shit. I cared about how I felt in here. And if I connected with people when I did that, that mattered and that was awesome. But as long as I was feeling good, that's really all that mattered. And it just so happens that the shit that I was feeling in here all those years, you guys were feeling it too. See, I never really gave a fuck of what people thought about me, what they thought I wanted to be, told me what I should be or who I should be. Never fucking cared about none of that. I just cared about living my life. If those people didn't want to be in my circle, then I just kept my circle small. Because fuck them. I don't need them in my life. If they want to judge me and tell me who I should be or what I should do, I don't need them. Yes, right, fuck them. Exactly, fuck them. But now they're in my DMs. Yo, remember me? Hey, you remember me from high school? Yeah, I remember you from high school. You were a fucking bitch. You were a fucking asshole. I ain't got no sympathy for dickheads. I never did and I never will. Just be real. Wear your heart on your sleeve. Don't let people tramp on it. And just be who you want to be in this life. And if there's people judging you for who you want to be in this life, they don't fucking matter. Now, this tour has been a long one. And if you guys follow us on social media, you know that we have been through some shit to get to the end of this. But from ashes to new is the motto. Never give up. Rise from the ashes. Make the world know your name. And it's exactly what we're doing out here. We're rising to the fucking top, and it's because we have no quit in us. We are just going to keep going until we get there. And once we get there, I don't know what's next, but I'm just grateful that y'all are going to be there with us. We have got 3 shows left after tonight until we go home, and I've got 2 kids at home. One's a baby, he's 3 months old, and then a 16-year-old, and I cannot wait. I cannot wait to see them. They are the love of my life. But I want to thank you guys, personally, from me to you. This right here gives my babies a better life. So thank you so much for supporting what we do. Because you guys supporting us also supports them. The same goes for all the other guys in the band and our crew. You guys supporting us gives us the life that we always dreamed of. And it just keeps growing and growing and growing, and I can't even imagine where it's gonna go from here. One other thing, and I know that other bands and artists say this. They say, hey, this is my therapy. I'm on stage, this is my therapy. And listen, I'm not here to tell you who means it and who doesn't. I'm here to tell you that I mean it. This is my therapy, and I'm very, very grateful that you guys show up for it, because it gives me the opportunity to get these dark thoughts out of my head. Going back to saying I don't give a fuck about what people think about me, I'm up here dancing around, jumping around, looking like a fucking fool, an idiot, making the dumbest faces in the fucking world, and you know what? I don't give a shit. I feel really fucking good doing it. So, thank you for letting me do that. Because I know that when this tour is over, and every other tour after this, I will go back home to my babies, and because you guys will have given me the opportunity to do it, I will have got those dark thoughts out, and I will be a better man for my kids. So thank you so much for allowing me to do that. Now, this next song is called Barely Breathing. You guys know this song? Chrissy Costanza from Against the Current couldn't be here tonight singing this song with us. Or could she? No, I'm fucking with y'all, but it's really cool to watch your reactions. And everyone got really excited, I'm sorry. Actually, I'm not sorry, that was fucking awesome. She's not here. But you know what, I need you guys to pick up where she's not at. Can you do that? Yeah! That was some weak sauce. Let's try that shit again. Can you do that? Yeah! This is Barely Breathing. Just went top 10 at rock radio. Say hello.
I'm not.
2013, this wasn't the original lineup. Actually, none of these guys were in the band. But I'm very grateful that I went through the hard times that I went through, losing the members that were in the band, because nobody believed in it the way that these three guys believe in this band. And this is exactly what the band should have been all along. So I'm gonna start off with my homie on drums back here, Mr. Matty Madeiro. Stubborn, strongest, most beautiful assholes I've ever met in my life. Look at him. I know, ladies, he's fucking drop dead gorgeous. I do. I've heard it enough. I don't see it, but you know, if you're thinking it, whatever, it must be true, right? Well, Mr. Matty Madeiro came in when I was at my worst times, fucking kicking me while I was down, but in a good way. He was like, get the fuck out, man. What are you doing, man? We got shit we gotta do. We got a band that we gotta put together. We got songs that we gotta write. Made me believe in myself all over again, the way that he's always believed in himself. This guy is one of the most confident sons of bitches I've ever met in my life. Everybody give it up for Mr. Matty Madeiro on drums. Now we started something new with this next guy. Apparently I have to call him like his spirit animal or whatever the fuck he is. I don't know why I gotta do this. It's just making me do weird shit. But when you got a nerd like Lance Dowell in your band, you gotta do weird shit. That's just the way it is. And like I said in my speech before this one, I embrace the weirdness, so man, let your freak flag fly, Lance. It's fucking way to fly. The most humble guitarist I've ever met in my life. I swear to God, this guy can shred Dragon Force with his fucking eyes closed. I'm not lying to you. But it doesn't matter to him. He plays what's put in front of him and whatever's better for the music. It's not about his own personal voyage. It's about what he can do for everybody else around him. Even though he is a cat at heart and he will fucking scratch you if you fuck with him and spill your milk off the side of the table. He's one of my very best friends on this planet. Everybody give it up for Mr. Lance Dowell on guitar. He's last. Come here, Danny. Come on. Don't let him fool you. His head's that big for a reason.
We have the exact same size head.
We're not talking about me right now. We're talking about you. Everybody, Danny Case on lead vocals. Danny came into the band in 2017. He was a little rough around the edges as a singer, but we knew that he was going to flourish, and one day he was going to be one of the biggest stars in this industry. Woo! He's making his way there right Woo! Now. And in realness, it wasn't about his voice or his technique or what he did as a vocalist. It was about his work ethic and his desire to win and to go to the top. And that's exactly what you need in this life if you're going to fucking do things the way that you want to do them. And that's exactly what Danny does day in and day out. Now, I know that he is probably the Ed Sheeran of metal. I hope I see at least 10 tweets tonight that say that. They're called tweets anymore. I don't know what they're called. But in 2017, he came in and he saved this band. We didn't know where we were going. We knew that we had the instruments and we knew we had the music, but we didn't have the voice. And in 2017, he came in, we released our first record, The Future, and from there, it's been this. The first song we released off that record was a song called Crazy. You guys know that song?
Yeah!
We were very concerned that you guys would think that Danny was a bitch because it was such a soft song compared to the things that we had put out previous to that. Lo and behold, we all know Danny is a bitch.
Sexy bitch.
Well, and if you shave his head, he will look like a human toe. But Crazy is our biggest radio song to date. Yeah! It's the song that started this lineup here the way that it should have always been. And it is the song that started to take us on our journey to the top. So, if you know the words, sing this song along with Danny. This song is called Crazy.
Woo! Oh my God.
Let's go.
One more time, give it up for Elijah.
Now our new album, Blackout Deluxe, just came out, I think yesterday. This next song was the first one from the Deluxe album with our homie Aaron Polly of A Mice and Men. You guys know the song, One Foot in the Grave? Now Aaron couldn't be here tonight. Or could he? We'll be right back.
Echo.
California, you've been fucking beautiful. Thank you so much for being here for the Blackout Tour. It means the world to us. It really does. This is our very last song of the night. All right, now it's not gonna be one of those situations where we play a song and we leave the stage and y'all chant that magical chant and then we come back out and play another song. It ain't fucking happening, all right? So this is the very last one. No peekaboo tonight, it's not happening. Hide and seek's a lot of fun. Maybe we'll go hide and you guys see if you can find us, but that's not going down that way. So, like most crowds on this tour, I'm gonna give you guys the opportunity to right now to get that shit out of your system. So if you want to chant one more song, right now's the time.
One more song!
Through it all. See you.